Anyway. So, last couple of things. We could listen to all the tapes. We could finish all the Paz's reports. Your spy log. These are just music. So. I'm right at the Valkyries. Here's to you. Alright. Let's just play football. Diaries.
Football, or soccer as it is known in the States, is extremely popular here. It has not caught on yet in the US, but it has legions of rabid fans all across Latin America. These fans can get so rowdy that it
what does this have to do with outer heaven?
El Salvador and Honduras went to war in 1969 over scuffles in a soccer match.
I doubt that's true.
In reality, tensions between the two countries were already high. The match was merely one of the sparks that set them off. But these people are so passionate about this sport that the story seems plausible. Predictably, many of the soldiers here are fans. They have apparently divided themselves into Costa Rican and Nicaraguan teams and started playing each other.
That's kind of funny.
To play, you need a ball and two goals. The R&D team built and set up simple goals on the deck. I had absolutely no interest.
But I don't like soccer or fun.
I come and watch. It was not a proper match by any means. The pitch was not even regulation size. But the players and spectators alike got pretty excited. They banged empty cans and shouted cheers through the handmade megaphones. It almost felt like carnival.
That's
Huey,
funny.
The referee, blew a whistle to start the match. The soldiers' training has left them in excellent physical shape.
Does Huey know anything
but
about soccer? He's American.
The skills of professionals, and their play was quite rough. Midway through, one of the men collided with another. They started shouting at one another, but Huey stepped in. I thought we had forsaken our countries, become one with the earth, he said, quoting Snake. We are not competing for national pride here, and we are not fighting for the good of any one country.
This is the boss's legacy.
This is not a war. Soccer is a peaceful sport, am I right?
The
soldiers
maybe.
Nodded. They know the pain of war, and they share Snake's vision. Perhaps that is why all this resonates with them. Team Costa Rica was down a man, and somehow I was picked to fill in. Up until that point. I suppose Huey wanted to keep it balanced. The soldiers agreed with Huey's call. Maybe the Costa Rican players felt an even matchup would be more fun, too. I could not be bothered to run at first. But chasing the ball out there in the hot sun, I was soon drenched in sweat. Before long, I found myself actively seeking out the ball, partially out of desperation. I picked up a loose ball deep on the opponent's side of the field. Even though he's Nicaraguan, Chico cheered me on, yelling, "Go for it, shoot!"
Good for
him. I launched the ball as hard as I could, only to have it blocked by the keeper. Disappointment only increased my determination. In the end, I didn't score a single goal, and Costa Rica gave up its lead. It was really close, though. We congratulated each other.
Not that I had fun or anything.
And sprawled out in the shade on the deck. Exhausted. The ocean breeze felt so nice on my sun-soaked body. Nuke came over. It is one of his favorite spots.
Oh yes, the cat.
And stretched out next to me. And together, we watched fluffy white clouds drift lazily across the clear blue sky.
So, Lee was talking about how the Orioles and the Nats are playing, and the Orioles are winning. So, helping out the Mets.
When Strangelove came up to me. Despite
Strangelove.
She was in her usual long sleeves and pants. I waited.
She's a weirdo.
She looked away and mumbled, "Hello there. Fancy meeting you here." I asked if she needed anything, feeling her eyes creeping up and down my body like she was savoring it.
Yeah, because she's into ladies.
Finally, she swallowed and said, "Have such beautiful skin." Bewildered, I shook my head and said, "No, not at all. I had heard rumors that she was a lesbian." But she couldn't be after me, could she? She continued to stare and
These tapes are silly.
No, it is beautiful. But you must not let yourself get so tanned. And then she took my hand in hers. What is wrong with a little sun, I asked, trying to cut the conversation short. But she shook her head violently. No, you mustn't. A young lady should take better care of
her
skin.
It is pretty bad for you to tan.
She was acting strangely now, as if aroused.
Oh, Japan.
She lectured me on the perils of tanning, how it ages skin, causing wrinkles and spots, and in the worst cases, even skin cancer. I knew already that tanning could cause spots, but I thought only pale-skinned Anglo-Saxons had to deal with that.
It's everybody.
Having a scientist tell me it causes aging, though, that spooked me a little. If I am to keep playing
so vain.
The teenager, I will have to start
right, yeah.
paying more
She's
attention
older.
To my skin.
She's a spy.
Sensing my anxiety, she took a small tube from her pocket. She said it was the sunscreen she always used. She told me to keep it. I didn't know what to say. I was more than happy to take it, but exactly what were her intentions? Was she merely being nice? Or is she really into me? Either way, there was no reason to refuse, I suppose.
Yeah, no reason not to. Keep your skin safe.
An out-of-shape woman does not pose any real threat to me. Having power means not being afraid. It is the same on a global scale. A country with nukes can dictate terms to a country without them.
To a certain respect, that's true.
I thanked her and took the tube. Then she offered to put some on for me.
Okay, this is where.
She put some lotion onto her fingers and began rubbing it into my chest. It happened so suddenly, and I was so taken aback that I did not even think to protest. She caressed my stomach with her long, white fingers, then slid them upwards between my bikini-clad breasts.
Oh my, this
but
is...
Wait, I sputtered as her moist eyes met mine. She was beautiful. Somehow, I found myself captivated by this woman more than 10 years my elder.
Nice work, strange love.
She whispered in my ear. I nodded silently, unable to refuse. My body went limp, motionless, as if in a trance. Gently, carefully, she rubbed the lotion all over my entire body. I shouldn't have enjoyed it. And yet, I could not help myself. For a moment, I was spellbound.
I didn't think it could happen to me.
That woman is dangerous. I had better watch myself.
I wonder if Strangelove is going to have much of a role
Protecting
in
oneself
Phantom
is
Pain.
An important part of any agent's job. But despite my best efforts, I have caught a cold.
Oh no!
Now that I think about it, Mother Base's numbers are on the rise. With soldiers
it's probably
coming
one
from
of those
all
guys.
Different places and backgrounds.
Filthy guys.
It is no wonder then. That sooner or later, someone would bring in a virus. That said, what I have got is just a common cold. The medical team said I'd need a few days rest, so I've been restricted to my room and put on bed
rest.
Nice work
for the voice actress with, like, the pinched nose or whatever.
I thought I got used to not having anyone around to relate to, but at times like these, being alone is just miserable. All I could do is
lay
there and stroke Nuke's back, trying to take my mind off how bad I felt. Nuke just sat there, not making a sound. But I did have visitors. Amanda and Chico, Huey, Cecile, Miller, and a few of the soldiers I've become relatively close to. Amanda made me a soup with herbs she said were good for a cold. Miller told me to take it easy. I will sing you a lullaby, he said.
Miller's gonna sing
a
lullaby?
Guitar and sang some incomprehensible song in Japanese. I did not need to understand the lyrics to know he is an awful singer.
Then he said, some serious shade.
You know what is good for a cold? Suppositories.
What?
Here, I'll show you.
Why is everybody just like...
He began to take off his pants, so I threw my tissue box at him to make him go away. Then, Strangelove showed up, saying she had some miracle Indian cure. It has got eucalyptus extract, she said. It works best if you rub it into
She's
your
just trying to run.
And then she tried to take off my nightshirt. I whacked her with my pillow.
Oh, this these diary entries.
Chico brought me a little flower in a cup. It had been growing in a little bit of earth that probably found its way on board, stuck to something else. I found this on the deck. Here, you can have it. He tried to act nonchalant, but I am pretty sure he's got a crush on me.
Yeah, I think so.
None of them understand. If they thought these little visits would cheer me up, they were wrong.
I'm so bad.
Tonight, Snake himself came to my room. Like the rest, he believes I am just a schoolgirl and treats me as such.
Look at him listening to the tapes, all sad.
Why did you abandon your country, I asked him. Why create the MSF? Of course, I knew the answers already, but I wanted to hear it from him. As I had imagined, he was not exactly forthcoming.
This is weird, he's actually pretty chatty.
His country abandoned him, because all he could do was fight. And that is why he needed the MSF, because that is all he is any good for. Then he said, fighting is the only thing I understand.
Fighting is the only thing I understand.
Against those who believe in peace. I am not one of them, and I do not believe in peace. Conflict is in man's
nature. I'm so bad.
We fight our enemies in order to survive. Maybe we are not so different after all, he and I.
No, probably not.
But that is exactly why I'm going to have to kill him. Or else he will have to kill me.
More likely.
When I stop and think about this wretched existence, being killed by a man like that suddenly does not seem like such a bad thing.
Man, she gets real depressed when she's sick.
Mother Base throws a party for all the soldiers whose birthdays fall in that month. There is something strange about a military organization having parties.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Really, though, it is just an excuse to drink and make noise.
The best things are.
It is not easy to get alcohol in a fortress in the middle of the ocean. Most days they are training from dawn till dusk. They do not have time for things like drinking. That is why
I always make time for that,
came up with the idea to give everyone a chance to let loose. Obviously, a bunch of boars like that are not going to bother with blowing out candles on a cake.
They're going to blow out candles in a bomb.
Sit there in a cloud of cigarette smoke, drink beer, eat meat, tell tasteless jokes, and swap crude insults about one another's hometowns.
That's pretty funny.
But
that sounds more
fun. Breaks out into something serious. They talk up a storm, but they're just having fun. It is funny. You have got members of FSLN rubbing shoulders with the UCLAs. People who once would have considered the other mortal enemies.
I was going to say, I don't think that's the university.
I wonder if that is what makes Big Boss so popular.
Yeah, he unites
people.
They're
leaving their countries behind. They leave their hatred for other countries, too.
Miller seemed a little
vision. Protective of me. Hope they're not being too crude, he said. But soon enough, he too was drunk. He
yelled, trying to put suppositories in my butt again.
And take a look at the real Kazuhira Miller. Then dropped his pants and mooned everybody.
Yep, the other soldiers see? Told you, drop his pants, but...
I have never seen such a crude, ridiculous party before. And yet...
They're so terrible. Ridiculous.
Laughing and acting a fool. Is this what they call peace?
I hate peace.
For some reason, I began to think about all that has happened since I came here. Fishing with Chico, cooking with Amanda and Cecile, playing soccer, having visitors when I caught a cold.
Oh, all these things that make somebody turn less evil.
My time here has been the most peaceful of my life. But that is about to end.
Uh-oh.
I cannot imagine you will be willing to negotiate. It
no.
seems I'm to fight the legendary Big Boss.
In a pink Metal Gear.
I do not know if I'll be able to beat him. But
you
if
won't.
I have to choose between death and defying Cypher, I will gladly choose death. The thought of dying does not scare me. But if I disobey my orders, the fear and despair awaiting me will be far worse than anything I can imagine. It was Cypher who took me in as an orphan, gave me food and a place to live. His orders may have been unreasonable, but I will never repay my debt entirely.
You don't know
it
him just because
I have
of that.
No choice. I must fight this man. I must fight Snake. Do you know Miller?
All right, almost there.
Snake's right-hand man. Apparently has got at least one serious weakness.
His butt.
He's an insatiable womanizer. He does not bother me. Most likely because he considers teenagers off-limits.
And yet he tried to put a suppository in your butt.
But he has hit on every single one of the few female soldiers here at Mother Base. They ought to be telling him where to stick it. But end up falling for it so easily. I think some of it stems from the fact that he is actually not that bad looking. Anyway, today, that nasty habit got him in trouble.
With who? This is interesting.
He and Snake got into one of their rare fights, and I was there to see it. They burst out of the showers completely naked, trading punches. I am not
Everybody's
childish.
Naked in
this
game. This
kind of a naked man does not make me blush, but this was something else. Maybe this'll teach you, Snake yelled as he slammed his fists into Miller's chest.
Ooh.
I heard later that apparently he had been two-timing someone, and that same someone had gone to Snake with her troubles. As I see it, it is her own fault for letting herself be deceived like that.
She's so stupid.
If she's too dumb to see through Miller's lies, then she got what she deserved.
Yeah.
But this was not the first time it had happened, or the second, and Snake read Miller the riot act. Miller argued back, and what began as a shouting match turned into a fist fight. You son of a bitch, Miller yelled as he swung. Not bad, said Snake, smiling. But not good enough. And then he was back on the offensive. They had already been at it
Snake.
Pretty hard in the showers, and their bodies were covered with bruises.
Both That's what she said.
Men had been trained for war.
Phrasing.
Their bodies, deadly weapons. They were each bleeding from a dozen places. All this from a fist fight.
Yikes.
Even so,
that's a pretty intense
fistfight.
It was
far less gruesome than if they had given it their all. It was obvious that one of them would be dead were they fighting for real.
Sure, yeah.
Miller took another swing, yelling, "Try this then!" Snake parried, then responded in kind. But I could tell he was not aiming for anything vital. You are one tough bastard, boss, Miller muttered. A smile crept across his face as he caught his breath. And then they went right on fighting. Blood and sweat flew off their glistening bodies. It was combat
Phrasing.
Without hatred or hostile intent. I had never seen violence like this before. And yet, it was more than just
steam.
A friendly tussle. They were utilizing every technique they knew. It was not a sporting match. They were not playing by the rules. How could they keep this up? At last, the two men tired themselves out, and the bizarre scene came to an end. They looked at each other's battered bodies, and then burst out laughing, embracing and congratulating each other
anime.
On a good fight. It all seemed so idiotic. I still cannot fathom such behavior. But somehow, I got the sense that for all his womanizing, Miller really only trusted one person, and that was Snake.
I don't think that that's really
there
that related
no
to his womanizing.
There was no way I could ever come between the two of them. And at that thought, I began to feel as if I had lost.
Was she supposed to plant the seeds of something there?
All of Mother Base is preparing for a festival. Since Snake and his soldiers
it's an anime,
spend so
I guess.
Much time fighting, they are setting aside one day a year for peace and relaxation. I do not know all the details, but apparently that is what Snake and Miller decided. These soldiers love the idea, of course. There is so little fun to be had here that everybody looks forward to events like these. That is all well and good, but somehow I got roped into getting on stage.
Is she gonna sing?
Come on, we even both have peace in our name, said Miller. And Zadarna,
oh, this is hilarious.
That old Ruski's name has something to do with peace too, right? Hey, as long as we are having a day of peace, we ought to get an act together. The Three Peace Band.
Yeah, because I think at this point Zadarnov's not dead.
He then proceeded to share his idea without bothering to check with me. And now, I am slated to sing. Apparently,
that's hilarious.
He had heard me on the deck one day, and since then he's wanted to form a band. Everybody's looking forward to it, so there is no way for me to back out now.
I can't believe this is how she's going to become
like
a good person.
But,
but she's not really.
It does feel kind of nice to know that people are looking forward to it. I mean, it cannot be any worse than Mueller's singing.
That's right, we established that.
But modifications to Zeke are already finalized. And I must complete my mission. Betray Sai for now. And I will face a fate far worse than death.
Yikes.
Still, there's no need to put things in motion just yet. What difference would it make to just wait a little while longer? A whole day of peace. The mission can wait until after.
But she hates peace.
Can it not? I know I'm only delaying the inevitable. When the day comes, one of us will have to die. Snake or me.
It won't be Snake.
If I could just come. come up with some way to stall Cypher, at least until our day of peace.
I get to sing. Did I start this having thoughts like this? Yeah, we
my
converted
cover
her.
Is blown. All right,
this is the last one.
They know nothing of Cypher or my true objective, but they know I am a spy. There is no more time left. I must act now. I must complete my mission. How did it come to
I forgot
this?
What blew her cover, but...
All I wanted was 3 more days. Just 3.
If only she could have sung in the festival, it would have been it.
The song. It is called Love Deterrent. It is about a girl who cannot express her true feelings.
It's about Paz.
I've been practicing. I am no pro, but I was pretty sure I would do a decent job. And now this.
Now
Cypher
this.
Found out that Zeke was complete. He must have someone inside Mother Base besides me.
It's a doorknob and Miller.
Wound web of control, leaving no room for individual will. Typical. When they found out Zeke was complete, I was ordered to execute the operation immediately. If I was going to enjoy just one day of peace, I had to ensure the plan could not move forward. I tried to sabotage Zeke. I thought by damaging the drive system, they would have no choice but to delay their plans. I waited until midnight.
That's an interesting thought.
And then snuck into the hangar. There would be trouble if it looked like sabotage. I selected one of the drive system's load-bearing parts and carefully worked to warp its shape. The legs drive system requires a high degree of precision to operate. Even the smallest deviation would have done it. Then, Chico walked in.
Chico.
Maybe it was one of those nights where he could not sleep. In any case, he saw me, panicked, and took off running. It would have been
Chico's
easy
such a putz.
To kill him. But I could not. I know he likes me. It is not as if I would ever have an interest in a child like him. But I could not pull the trigger. Not at him. Not in the back. Will he tell them? Or is there a chance he will keep it a secret? Protect me.
Yeah, I don't remember what blows the cover out. If it's a Darnov. No, I don't think he does.
He knows I am not who he thought I was. He ran without even questioning what I was doing. There is no chance he does not know. And soon, all I have built here will end. And if Cypher has another agent among them, if he finds out I tried to sabotage Zeke, this place will no longer be my heaven.
Yep, gotta go.
Then it is settled. I make my move now. Chico walked in before my sabotage was complete, so Zeke should still be operational. It might not run at full speed or power, but I do not have time to fix that.
Oh, okay.
Without
just make
Zeke,
it seem like I beat it because
I
was a little bit broken.
I must act fast before Chico sounds the alarm. I knew it would come to this. I just did not think it would be so soon.
Aw, sorry, Paz. If Chico ruins everything.
Zeke. Metal Gear Zeke, activate.
Okay. So, I'm not familiar with these. Let's listen to these. And then... God, there's so many. Okay. I should have enough time for at least this set, if they're not too long.
I heard about Paz's tapes. Yeah. Why do you think she'd leave him behind? And that diary?
Whatever it was, her commitment was wavering. That much is clear.
So she was leaving clues to help us?
No way.
I don't know about that.
Sure. And the ocean's not giving her back.
So these are recorded with Kiefer, so these must be new ones.
November 4th, 1974. At the outskirts of Barranquilla,
Barranquilla.
Colombia. Contact with Big Boss successful. Zadornov posed as my professor, but Big Boss took one look and knew he was KGB. However, he does not seem to suspect me. To him, I am just a peace-loving student and another victim of the CIA. We asked him to drive the CIA out of Costa Rica.
La CIA.
Him, this means betraying his country. His forces are smaller than anticipated. They drift from place to place with nowhere to call home. That provided us an opportunity. So we
give him that little platform.
Zadornov offered them a plant off the Costa Rican coast to use as a base. As expected, Miller jumped at the chance. Although initially reluctant, Big Boss came around when Zadornov played him the tape.
It's because it was the boss.
Because the voice on it sounded like his mentor, the boss.
Alright, what's next?
Naked Snake, the man who once saved the world from the brink of nuclear war. Awarded the title of Big Boss for his service. He later became a mercenary, abandoning both his title and his country. To him, that honor was steeped in the blood of the boss, the mentor.
Yeah,
he
was not pretty happy about it.
Exceptionally charismatic, he possesses unparalleled combat and intelligence gathering abilities. His only discernible weakness is
her.
This operation hinges on how effectively we can exploit that.
I wonder how much of that was
Miller
part of that too.
Big Boss's lieutenant, half Japanese, half American. He once served in Japan's self-defense force.
He also got beat up by Big Boss.
Snake first met as enemies. They discovered a common bond and together built their private army, with Miller directing business and administrative affairs. He comes off as shallow, but his true intent is hard to read. I must be careful. All that is clear is his infatuation with Big Boss. With East and West fighting over its control, Central America is now the most contested region on Earth.
Yep.
CIA Central American Station Chief Coldman has developed.
I keep looking over at the TV, and the Pope is doing Vesper service.
His fully AI-automated, failed deadly nuclear launch system, with which he aims to reignite the Cold War.
Failed deadly, such a funny turn of phrase. Instead of fail safe.
The doorknobs, or should I say, the KGB's plan is to play the two sides against each other, turning the entire region red. Not one of the three parties realize they're all just pawns in Cypher's hands. Cypher watches all.
Interesting. I didn't realize that Cypher was part of it, too.
Mother Base has developed rapidly since being established in the Caribbean Sea. They recruit more personnel daily,
oh, okay.
And already their mercenary services are turning a profit. Big Boss's leadership and charisma, and Miller's business acumen drive this impressive growth. Furthermore, joining forces with a faction of the FSLN has expanded their power
it's
even
with
more.
Amanda's,
they have even commenced their own weapons development program. All is
Yeehaw.
Proceeding according to Cypher's will. I could not.
Did he want that? I guess they had to become more powerful to then maybe join him
Snake's
to be the cover for it.
Led him to an AI modeled after the boss's thought patterns. It was incomplete, but somewhat ironically, making contact with Snake was the necessary finishing touch.
Yeah, that's what caused him to break with
the scientist behind
the boss's vision.
Locomotive control Huey defected to Snake's army. His presence has greatly accelerated weapons development at Mother Base.
Then he gave us that bad nuke idea. Maybe it was Miller.
Madness, but nuclear war was averted.
Yeah, that was close.
However, this was only after the boss AI on board Peacewalker sank itself to the bottom of the lake in what
this is what actually radicalized Snake.
The boss laid down her gun, choosing to sing for peace instead, and Snake, himself a gun, parted ways with her. In
yep.
doing so, he reclaimed the title he once abandoned. He is Big Boss.
Alright, this is her now.
Zadornov has been detained. Since this
she keeps
my
letting
cover
loose.
Identity without a guardian, the Mother Base staff has taken me in. I am now better placed than ever to monitor their internal affairs. Everything continues to unfold according to plan. The developer of the boss AI, Dr. Strangelove, has also come to Mother
She's
Base.
She's helping with developing
with
Zeke.
Her and Huey's expertise, they can now develop a weapon capable of matching Peacewalker.
Alright, Zeke.
Development on the bipedal weapon is now complete. They call it Metal Gear. That
means she's gotta steal it now.
It stands there like some sort of mystical guardian. The soldiers gaze on it with pride and reverence. Big Boss has elected to arm it with a nuclear weapon. As an army without a nation, they seem to feel
the
need for
superpower,
a deterrent against
nuclear
whatever
power.
The world might pit against them. It is a dangerous gambit. Why do such a thing? Their nuclear strategy differs from the Americans and the Soviet Union. The superpowers deter attack by revealing their nuclear arsenals to one another. Snake and his men know that if they were to go public with this,
they'd be
the
destroyed.
Whole world would unite against them. Business would dry up overnight.
They'd be considered probably a terrorist organization.
So they do not plan on revealing the nuke until necessary. This ace in the hole approach is their idea of a nuclear strategy. Wielding a deterrent, all the while unable to reveal its existence. I wonder if Snake sees how vulnerable this makes them.
Alright, what's this?
Yes. Hijack Zeke? Yes, I did indicate that to be our leverage. But I cannot imagine
he's agreeing
to that
do.
Now. But did you not raise them to safeguard your governance without borders? No, no. I have not forgotten. Cypher watches
all. Communicating with Cypher, yeah. Alright, and what's this next one?
Yes, things are proceeding. But modifying Zeke has not proven easy. I am using Zadornov to buy some time.
Alright, because she has to become a
pilot. I have not forgotten what you said. However.
However.
Well, forgive me for asking, but this is you I am speaking to, isn't it? Cypher.
It could be a robot.
I must. I will fight Big Boss. The world must be ruled by a single will. To defy Cypher is a fate worse than death.
That's scary. Speaking of scary and defying Cypher, so let's listen to these, and then we're gonna listen to Chico's tapes. Do not use them. Oh, is this just? Oh, yep. That's funny. Okay. Nope. Stop. Stop. Okay. Oh, because this is like what they were saying, like proof that this is a black site. Oh, so for this area of the tapes, by the way, I'm going to put a note in the video that might have a timestamp, but pretty much trigger warning type stuff, you know, torture, rape, stuff like that, that might be part of these tapes. So if you're sensitive to that, you might not want to listen to all of these tapes. All right. So let me fast forward. I think this is Skullface talking.
You've done your part. You told us plenty. You've known the pain of ages. And even now you think, as any person would, that this can't be happening. Is it education?
This is sort of a Skullface's manifesto, maybe.
Just the imprint of a lifetime of stories. Face to face with oblivion, which is where you are, and you still think that help is coming. The world you were born into is made to save you. Isn't that right?
No, this is some grim stuff.
Of course it is. Everyone knows that. Until your last breath, you know it. Without the slightest chance or reason left to them, humans are capable of hope. I'm no different. But for one thing, when my time came calling, I didn't die.
Is that why his face is all
family died,
scarred up?
My country died. But they didn't take me with them. All hell took from me was this skin.
Yeah, this that's why he's got that gross thing.
That marked me human. My village had an oilseed field and a fine factory.
I don't know what an oil seed is.
Every day, my friends and I would see our oil parents seed. At work in that factory. That's all I had. All the world I knew. Then one day, aircraft came droning in from some far-off sky. The factory
this
was
end
bombed.
Well. Yep.
Some spies had told them we were making weapons. The building burned. We tried to flee.
Is this when he
outside.
Lost his skin? Or is this from somewhere else? The crowd blocked
the exit. The crowd of people. Hot. So hot. I tried to push through their legs and get ahead, but a boot in my stomach put me on the ground.
Yikes.
The smoke of them burning filled me up. I heard my name called, but not for long.
I don't know what his actual name is.
At the infirmary,
why is he recording this, I guess?
A nurse in the corridor saw me and remarked, as if it happened every day, they should let the poor thing die.
So he hasn't had skin since he was a kid.
Those are the words of my mother tongue I remember. It was the language of my village. Until foreign troops invaded. Then the last identity I had left, the words I spoke, were pulled from me.
This is an important theme for the Phantom Pain, language.
Never feel anything again.
And identity.
This face would be
he doesn't feel anything either.
In torture, at foreign hands. But I still writhe in that burning factory.
Why burn somebody's face if it's already burned?
Rapeseed oil. That's all I have to feel. That pain. All I have to remind me I exist here. Those spies reported well. We made weapons, all right. As cartloads of rifles came in from the battlefields, we fixed them up and sent them back out, so our country
sucks
could win.
That they got all hurt
or rather,
that.
So that little world we knew could continue. I came to realize I mustn't die. I'm their last hope. All those who perished and left me here. I have to accomplish something. If I don't, their will be swept out of this world.
The will of the people from this village?
So, do you see me now? Tell me.
Don't look at him.
What do you see?
There's a lot of, he's seen my face, kill him.
You have eyes? What do your eyes see? Yes, that's right. You see a skull face. You see me. This skull is who I am. My mark, my proof of humanity. I have no
I guess it's missing any sort of
no
ethnic
language,
thing.
I have no face, but I haven't lost my skull.
In a way, it strips people down to the most human elements.
The pain and effort that keep me alive will never know relief, never bear fruit, never be repaid. I know that. But I told myself to focus on some hope, a non-existent hope, to guide me through this burning world.
Huh.
A hope. Call it a dream. A melancholic delusion. As the pressures within me stretch me to bursting, and I force myself not to cry out, though the words I thought were carved into me are gone, and all I knew is dead. I know how you feel. I've felt that. So show me that I'm not the only one. That you too can return to this world for revenge.
Revenge is one of the other big things. The cycle of revenge and the way that revenge works.
Don't die. Don't die.
Maybe you shouldn't have tortured him so much. Okay, so Chico's tapes. Like I said, that last one was disturbing. These are disturbing too. This is arrival in Cuba.
I made it ashore. I'm in Cuba. Security looks lighter than I thought. I wonder where Paz is.
The weird thing is that the guy who does his voice is the same one who does Pit, like in Smash Brothers.
He's dark, but there are soldiers everywhere.
And Kid Icarus, which is so much less heavy.
Those lights are so bright. Time to get moving.
Maybe he shouldn't be narrating his infiltration. Snake doesn't narrate his infiltrations.
I got close to the fence to see if I could spot her. They had a guard posted, so I got out of there. Guess security's not so light after all. I'm coming, Paz.
Useless.
I'm okay. I'm okay. I think I found her. It's gotta be Paz.
He's gonna get caught really soon.
No, no, no. I'm looking for me.
Yeah, there's no way he gets. They should use dogs against me. Although I like not having to fight off dogs.
No, quit that struggle. Got him secured.
Well.
The kid.
Is that that's the song that plays when you fight Paz? The first time I played this, I didn't know that, so I didn't even. That didn't mean anything to me.
I got caught.
Yeah, you pots.
I'm in a cage. Give me back my recorder. At least whoever finds this will know what happened. They're holding others here too. Still no sign of Paz.
I thought he saw Paz before, or maybe there's no sign of her since he got caught. What are they dragging this way? No, let's pause. I think this will be newly recorded dialogue. Maybe. Shouldn't have come. All right, next tape. Recordings from his cell. 2.5 minutes. I hate these tapes. I don't know that I've heard all of them, but I've heard a good chunk of them.
Don't touch me, you son of a bitch.
I can't quite do his voice, but it's always like, "Bus." Oh, she's punching her. Birds. Must be like morning. It sounds like morning. They should smack Chico around.
looks weak. We need her alive. Yes, sir.
Paz.
Huh?
You're back early today.
Early?
And the sun is still up.
These are so rough.
Yeah.
Chico.
Yes?
Let us not do this, okay?
Huh?
I do not think I want to talk to you.
But...
Oh, wow.
I came here to...
Just quiet. Or I'll scream.
What the... I don't get it.
Okay, this one is the one that's like extra bad, I think. Or maybe it's the interrogation.
On your feet.
Okay.
Or maybe this is supposed to be the one that helped us. Yeah, this is the one that helped us find find where he is. It's gonna be like a car and then like a flag and stuff like that. So. Yeah, that's what this one is. Here's the interrogation. So this one is definitely a not fun one to listen to. No, this one's 10 minutes long, shit. Like 13 minutes, and I have probably more than that in tapes.
Does it hurt? Talk. Talk. You can speak, can't you?
Sorry, I had to get up, get my phone.
Okay.
Good boy. Your boss and I go way back. Don't count on him coming to rescue you. If you're a real soldier, you'll find your own way out.
I've never heard of him before, so...
But don't bother trying to escape. Let's say you get lucky. And you don't look very lucky. And by some miracle, you get out of your cage. Let's even say you're able to elude the guards. Then what? The nearest Cuban border is 4 miles to the east. 4 miles of barren America-controlled soil. Think you'd make it?
Probably not.
You wouldn't get any help from the Cubans. And the border's a mess of live minefields. Think you'd make it through that? With your girlfriend in tow? If you were that lucky, you wouldn't even be here right now.
How did he get there in the first place?
But don't lose hope. There's another way out for both you and the girl. This way is much simpler.
And also a trap.
I ask, you answer. Easy, right? Just tell me what you know.
You're dumber than you look.
wasting your time torturing kids.
Well, Chico. Chico gives up all the time.
Tell me about your base.
Chico.
Well?
Chico!
Hit me! Again!
Trying to impress the girl, little man? How cute. All right.
It's not gonna be cute in a second.
Let's try something else.
Oh, nice slapping her around.
Stop it!
Hate this.
She'll get what she deserves. We were comrades once.
Oh, but he's from Cypher? I guess it...
Deception and deceit. What better proof she's a real woman?
That's not cool.
Show him.
Do you realize what you're doing? Cypher is watching. Let go of me. You will be next. Your hideous face will...
No, jeez. Sorry, guys. Remember, Chico is a child. I mean, he's a teenager, but he's a child. Like, this is wrong on, like, every level.
Repulsive, isn't it? Look. Look carefully. Watch out when you grow up, boy.
This
is the kind of woman you'll want to avoid. Of course, scars like those make it rather difficult to lead a normal life. I should know.
His whole face is just burns and scars.
Continue. Talk, and you both go free.
Chico! No!
Only you can stop this.
Don't talk!
Oh man. So fucking gross. No! It's mostly implied, but it's shitty. It's terrible.
Why?
This is more of the fight music from...
Move. Get up. You heard me. Do you like what you see? I said, do you like what you see?
This is so awful.
Fruit. Does she look sweet or sour? A man has to know these things. Time for a taste test. Either you take her now, or you're strung up next.
This is shitty. He's a kid.
Chico.
No. No.
It is okay. Chico. You won't hurt me.
I don't.
Get on with it.
I can't.
Chico.
No.
Come on.
Awful.
Out at sea? Staff of 300? But usually there's...
Squealing. Breaks so easily.
happen again.
See? That wasn't so hard.
You got what you wanted. Are you satisfied?
We're halfway there.
Living on a prayer. It's terrible. I still have about a minute and a half of this one. This one's the worst one.
Chico?
I thought you didn't want to talk to me.
There's one thing I want to say.
What?
I missed you, Chico.
Aww.
Yeah.
Come here.
Huh?
Closer.
Oh, boy.
Enough already.
You want to do it here?
Come on, Buzz, talk!
Okay, we have a couple more. I actually have to go, but I'm just gonna just let this finish.
It'll
be a little bit late. Making him torture him.
How can you say that?
Or making him torture
Traitor!
Him.
Don't make me mad. You're only making things worse.
Chico's super weak.
Take him back to his cage.
What did I do?
Беги, тека кат от себя.
Take his recorder or whatever.
Enough. She's no good to us dead.
Can I have it back?
We've decided right. to let her
with
go.
The, right, this isn't like when he gives him the thing.
So, she talked. Told her she should have just gotten it over with.
She's going back to your boss.
Interesting.
But only her.
Huh?
Those were the terms. She said to leave you here. I suppose she doesn't much care for you anymore.
That bitch.
Or if it's a real prisoner's
dilemma
thing.
You've got quite a problem on your hands. When she gets back, what will she say? That you talked? Sold out your comrades?
He did.
Your family? You're finished.
This kid's such a chump. He falls for everything.
You mean I can't go home?
There's very little I can do for you. And I still have need of your services.
Huh?
With what?
You're going to call your boss for help. We'll make a recording, play it across public frequency bands.
To bring him here?
This is the thing that eventually got us to come.
Yeah, right. Do you expect me to trust you? I'll never help you!
Perhaps. But if you did, I wouldn't mind looking the other way if he did come for you. Take some guards off duty, let you quietly slip away. But You wouldn't want the girl leaving here alive. She'd have to be eliminated before he came. There's no other way.
She goes the worst.
I'll leave you to think it over. Chico, growing up means choosing how you're going to live your life.
Snake, it's Chico. I need your help. Cypher's holding me on the U.S. military base in Cuba.
Jesus, I need it to be shorter. I need to go.
Boss is here too. We're at the prison area on the coast. There's some cages to the east of a big building. East an old grassy facility. That's where we are.
That's where he is.
Help me, Snake.
Well, I guess that's why he said Paz is dead when he, when Snake was grabbing him.
Don't do it.
Kids are natural, don't you think? What do you think Big Boss will do? He'll know it's a trap, but he'll come anyway. That's the kind of man he is.
Don't.
Thanks to your report, a nuclear inspection team's being sent to their base.
It's a fake.
The scientist was our way in.
What
it all ends
we do?
Exactly as I've planned. All thanks to you.
Cypher. Would never.
Yes, Cypher will surely mourn his death. I'll have no choice but to distance myself from the group.
Interesting.
And then they'll eliminate you. No one will be left. Think about that. Big Boss or Cypher? You can only save one.
There she goes for Big Boss.
I don't expect you to believe me.
Chico's the one who always talks.
The question is, which of the two would you like to give a shot at survival?
What I would like is to kill you.
The feeling is mutual. But we are secret agents. Restraint is a virtue. Your favorite song. Nicolas Bart. Immigrants wrongly executed. But their death served as a message to others. That ours is a society that murders the innocent.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Do you too believe your sacrifice will change the world? If so, the time is now. Cypher's been in hiding ever since his grand experiment. No one's seen him in years. All we hear are orders delivered by proxy. Except you.
This is weird. I didn't know about that. David O.
Face to face in order to contact Big
Boss. Oh, he wants Cypher's location.
Tell me where he is. Where is Cypher? Where is Zero?
Nobody knows where Zero is.
I
know that.
Known choice.
Oh, I forgot.
Where I was born, the language I speak. I've never had the freedom to choose for myself. But you, right now, are free. Do as you will.
This will save Big Boss.
It may.
Will you really kill Zero for me?
Not
that is what
you.
She wants.
All right. Zero is
I wanted to know where he was. Please be a short one. 6 minutes.
Give her the shot already. Hold her still.
Oh, this is like when they're operating on her. So maybe this is like in the space of time, like the time skip sort of.
She's all closed up.
Timer set for your instructions. We can't have her waking up or dying on us.
I gave her a transfusion, a nutrient cocktail, and an anesthetic.
How long does she have?
24 hours, same as her cargo. She won't last much longer than that. To make room for the bomb, I removed organs she won't need.
Aw, gross. That's terrible.
Almost there. Now for the second one. In a place they'd never look.
Aw, that's gross. That's awful. I mean, we kind of knew that already, but still. Sorry, guys.
Hang her up.
I'm so late.
You shall not see triumph. You've been most helpful. And I have one last use for you. To you, I give a magnificent end. But an end, nonetheless. The final moment is yours.
It's crazy.
We heard from the advance team. Everything's right on schedule. The C4 has been planted on the legs. Strike team and decoy team are in position.
Oh, they've already had that set up, huh?
A shame I won't see him. But at least I'll get a look at his body. Time for us to move out, too. But first, let's stop by and see the board.
This is where the beginning of the...
I want Big Boss to hear his little diary. Hopefully, he's still a good listener.
This is where this leads up to him, like, taking the boy as a reward
and a memento. Make copies.
Yes, sir.
First Big Boss, then Zero. Liberation is at hand.
Chico, I am borrowing your recorder. I hope you do not mind. I know it hurts right now, but it will all be over soon.
So late. Come on, hurry.
Just thinking that helps keep the pain away. Chico, I would do anything to get you out of here. It is funny. I have never helped anyone else before. Only Cypher. That is the truth. I never imagined you would come for me. I was not very nice at first, I know.
Yeah, because she needed to come around by playing soccer.
I was afraid they would try to use you somehow.
They did.
Honest, having you with me here put my mind at ease. I hope that does not sound selfish, but I would never make it. Together. I think we can.
Don't think so.
I record this. You have made me believe that I will make it out of here.
I guess you do, yeah.
No matter what happens, it will not be the end for me. Thank you, Chico.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. Crazy. Okay, thanks for watching. This has been Dan Plays Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes. I'm Dan. This is Ground Zeroes. See you next time.